Hi again. In the previous Chapter 7 videos, we recorded sales-related transactions for Wine Country Gift Shop into the Sales and General Journals and posted the transactions to the General Ledger accounts and the Accounts Receivable Subsidiary Ledger. In this final Chapter 7 video, we will continue the exercise by using the balances on the individual customer cards in the Accounts Receivable Subsidiary Ledger to prepare a schedule of accounts receivable at the end of the month. This video will continue using the same worksheets that you prepared for the previous lectures. Let's get started. Turn to the schedule of accounts receivable for Wine Country Gift Shop, located at the end of the worksheets provided for these lectures. As you can see, there is a heading for the worksheet, but no balances have been recorded yet. All you need to do is record the customer's name and account balance as shown on their ledger card in the Accounts Receivable Subsidiary Ledger and include all customer balances. Let's get started. The cards are in alphabetical order. So let's start with Joel Bennett. Joel Bennett owes us $81. Joel Bennett, $81. Next is Gordon Dunn. Gordon Dunn owes us $162. Gordon Dunn, $162. Ken Hamlet is next. Ken owes us $216. Ken Hamlet, $216. Vicki Neal owes us $270. Vicki Neal, $270. And Amy Poloza owes us $432. Amy Poloza, $432. Next, find the total of accounts receivable per customer cards by adding up this column. I get $1,161. Put the word totals next to that word, or next to that total. And finally, you need to compare the total receivables in the accounts receivable subsidiary ledger with the balance of accounts receivable shown in the general ledger account for accounts receivable. If the balances agree, all is well. But if the balances don't agree, then there is an error somewhere, either on the schedule of accounts receivable or recording to the accounts receivable subsidiary ledger and finding customer balances on their individual cards, or perhaps an error was made in posting to the general ledger and getting the balance in the general ledger account. The point is that the general ledger accounts receivable is the control account, and the details provided in the accounts receivable subsidiary ledger must agree with the general ledger balance. Any errors must be found and fixed before the accounting for the month can be completed. Let's check to see if our accounts receivable subsidiary ledger agrees with the general ledger. Our general ledger says accounts receivable is 1161. Our schedule of accounts receivable agrees, so we're okay. Well, that's all for Chapter 7. Please don't hesitate to send me an email if you have any questions on Chapter 7 or the Chapter 7 video exercises.